This is in fact a continuation of sustained and systemic Hindutva violence.
Incited mob violence in Delhi on the basis of someone's faith brings back painful personal memories,
stoking fear amongst all quarters of society across that country.
It's heartbreaking to see the violence in India.
Mr. Speaker, we must learn from history, not be fooled by those whose insidious aim is to divide society, hell-bent on killing and destroying religious places, all in the name of religion. Persecution of Indian Muslims, many of whom have been peacefully protesting against the Citizenship Amendment Act, is utterly intolerable, and that the police cannot just stand idly by, or worse still, be complicit, as is alleged by many victims and social activists, and that the perpetrators must feel the full force of the law.
Calling the recent violent community clashes seeks to normalise a far more sinister event. India is now controlled by Hindutva supremacist RSS ideology with strong historic link to the Nazi party, and the current Prime Minister of India was a member of the RSS. What step is the Prime Minister taking to call out this discriminatory practice at the heart of the Indian government?
Will the Minister join me in rejecting language of riots, clashes, protest and communal violence when this is in fact a continuation of sustained and systemic Hindutva violence waged on the Muslim and many minority ethnic communities in India that is sanctioned by Modi's BJP government?
First, with significant Indian Muslim communities will have seen videos showing shocking orchestrated sectarian violence. Can I encourage the Minister to invite the Indian High Commissioner to his office to share with him the deep concern of so many of our constituents about their families and friends' current lives in India? And if there is one silver lining in this very dark cloud, it is what one Gujarati Muslim said to me, which is that he and his family now value even more than ever the pluralism and safety across faiths that this country provides.